Here is the wallet of digital Renminbi or E-Cny or Dcep, which means digital currency electronic payment. A few years ago, following a boom of cryptocurrencies plus Facebook's announcement of launching Libra, the Chinese government started to reveal their first plans to launch their own digital payment. And guess what? It's already here in China. It can be accessible for all people here. And in this video, I will tell you the history of Dcep. I will tell you what is it. And at the end of this video, I will show you how to open your own digital wallet using your own banking app and how to purchase something in the store. Stay tuned! If you're seeing any value in this video, please don't forget to subscribe and give this video a thumbs up. And please don't forget to leave some comments, because then I will know what I should cover in the next videos and how can I improve my channel. So what is the history of Dcep? In the late 2013, Bitcoin made its first rise in China. Later on, the China Central Bank set up a research institute dedicated to the digital currencies and started to learn how to deal with the impact of cryptocurrencies and how to improve Chinese renminbi using blockchain technology. But from that time, the progress was quite slow. Perhaps they realized that the decentralized architecture of the blockchain technology is incompatible with the very nature of legal national currencies such as renminbi. However, in 2019, the acceleration of Dcep was directly attributed to the Facebook's launch of Libra, and the tensions between the US and China has made their own impact. So this left China with feeling the pressure urgent international growth in terms of digital currencies. There are a few more reasons why PBOC thinks Dcep is so beneficial, and actually some of these reasons I included in my master thesis a few years ago. When I was explaining the flows of all these third-party payment platforms such as Alipay and WeChat. So you heard that Ant Financial's IPO was suspended recently, and one of the reasons it was that the Chinese government appears to view the payment platforms as a destabilizing force for China's economy, because such third-party payments collect the user's data and to provide a better credit and loans, and no one wants to use the banks anymore. It's a very powerful source to have, because they also can invest your money into the funds that they have partnerships with. So it's very biased. And when dealing with payments, because they are private companies, they can easily choose a merchant that they could be benefited from and decided not to go with another merchant. But most importantly, they can default so much easier than the banks and the government. So in last year, in 2020, the Chinese government announced their first trials of the digital payments in 4 cities. By today, in 2021, it's officially launched and can be used when you pay for certain items in the stores or anywhere else. So what is Dcep? Dcep is 1-to-1 to renminbi, a Chinese national currency. It has two operational systems. The PBOC issues Dcep to the commercial banks, who distribute it to the individuals via the banking apps that are authorized by PBOC, Central Bank of China. And potentially, it is definitely a threat to the financial institutions, because PBOC directly faces the customers. So potentially it doesn't need any banks at all. However, the possibility of removing the banks out of this chain is highly unlikely, because that's why it has 2 tiers of operational system. Dcep uses cryptographic technologies and some blockchain concepts in a very centralized nature. It's not all a blockchain digital ledger technology or DLT. It's a mixed system. PBOC emphasized that DLT is not that mature enough to handle such large-scale applications, so because it should be able to handle around 300,000 transactions per second. And WeChat and Alipay, just for your information, can handle even more these days. It also has smart contracts, but PBOC has announced they're not planning to use it yet. Well, let's see in a few years. And regarding the users, from the user's perspective, there is not that much difference if they use WeChat or Alipay or Dcep or Google Play, Yandex Pay. It's all the same but different. Dcep has three main points that it is necessary to highlight. So first of all, it cuts the whole infrastructure of the payment platforms such as Google Play or Yandex Pay or WeChat Pay because it has low transactional cost, and also reduces card networks such as Visa or MasterCard. Dcep works without any internet, so it can work really well in the rural communities that don't have any access to the internet yet. And potentially during the apocalypse, we can still use Dcep. However, it still requires to top up the money, so it still requires to have some network. Not sure about this point. And also it is more hygienic, and during the coronavirus, some shops stopped accepting cash. And PBOC, I've heard a rumor, destroyed 6 million of worth of paper money. Among disadvantages, I would highlight that it lacks users' privacy. Although it was said that users will have some privacy sometimes with certain limits at a certain time. However, there is no details over that. If you ask my opinion, I think there is no privacy at all. So what are the advantages for the state? It does provide better monitoring. It guarantees monetary sovereignty. It can potentially oversee all the highs and lows and can avoid economical crises. So it brings real stability to the economy. It helps to stop tax evasion, money laundering, terrorist financing, and it's also less cost for the cash management. I'm a foreigner. I was not able to access the Dcep wallet yet through my banking app. However, I asked my friend Freya to proceed all the steps to obtain this Dcep wallet and link it to the banking app. Of course, we purchased some jacket from a shop, so I will show you how exactly it works, how you can access it, and what are the steps. Hey guys, today we will pay with Dcep.
Users can access the Dcep wallet by opening their banking app, filling in their password. Users will be able to open the app, however, they will not be able to access it until they register in the wallet. So they will have to write their name, surname, proceed their verification process. After that, the users will have to link their banking card to the wallet in order to be able to access full scope of the features, such as top up, withdraw money, transfer money.
I guess I don't know how much you want to buy for Zara, then we can top up for dinner, and then you transfer to me and they can direct. It's like Alipay.
Yeah, it's like Alipay.
So once the user opens an account, so connects his wallet to his banking app, this account will be a subject of a transactional limit. So if the user wants to have a higher limit, such user would need to provide full identification, similar as what it is required to open a banking account. This would ensure that users will remain anonymous to each other, but will allow the central bank to keep track on necessary data to implement good regulation and crack down on money laundering and other criminal offenses.
Now you know a lot about Dcep, how it works. So what about the future? So what is the future of Dcep? Well, due to the tensions between the US and China, the US can theoretically restrict dollar access for China over SWIFT, and Dcep can avoid this because potentially it doesn't require any banks at all. And for the users, it is hard to predict if Dcep will be accepted so fast as Alipay and WeChat those days. However, I think everything depends on the government. If the government decides that all the merchants have to accept Dcep, then of course it will be adopted really, really soon. Actually, these days I see more and more restaurants and stores that start to accept Dcep, so I guess we're going to the exponential growth. I guess in 2021 it would be the year when China is testing adoption of digital payments, and in 2022 it can unveil this progress to the whole world. As for other currency, we could already hear some plans for the Fed coin, for example, even though it's still theoretical. But it is widely discussed here in China and I think everywhere in the world in financial circles. Well, the viability of such electronic payments and cryptocurrencies is limited to the volatility and lack of backing by the central bank. Tether is an example of a stablecoin that claims to be backed by the US dollar. However, in the absence of the central regulation, that means it is not very transparent. Originally, Tether claimed that every coin that is issued is backed by the US dollar. However, it was discovered that only 74% of Tether is actually backed by dollars. It is also a stable coin, so some volatility still exists in this exchange for the US dollar. So Fedcoin would solve this problem, and it would be issued by the United States government and would be backed to the dollar for all times. Fedcoin would also allow fast transactions and cheaper transaction fees, and I think the United States government should really follow the China steps of adopting digital currencies. And we also hear that other countries have started to develop and test their digital payments, and some countries such as El Salvador just adopted Bitcoin as their legal currency. And what about your currencies? Does your government plan to launch any digital payment soon? And what do you think about El Salvador adopting Bitcoin as their legal payment? Please let me know what do you think about it. I would be really interested to know your opinion on these topics.